I think we were the very first in the country to actually start a search engine marketing, which was way back in 2004.
You're the oldest company on digital. In this last two decades, there have been several companies on digital that have come up and gone bust. How does marketing work for you?
So I think because we've been a digital business, a good thing was that we could measure everything that we were doing right from the beginning.
Right.
And we didn't wait for digital marketing really to come in.
Right.
Because everything that we did had a digital footprint.
Right.
So we were the first, almost, I think we were the very first in the country to actually start search engine marketing,
right,
which was way back in 2004.
Right.
So we did a lot of digital things first because it made perfect sense for us. But in our mix, TV was a part of our mix as well. We had the famous Hari Sadhu commercial.
Right.
So we basically would do TV for brand awareness, which is top of the funnel. People should know about our businesses. We were lucky that we could create good TVCs and people remembered them. We used to do Google AdWords.
Right.
Google had not even set up shop in India at that time. Then around 2008, is when we really aggressively started doing SEO as well.
Right.
So we started SEO in about 2006, but 2008 is when we really got our act together.
Right.
And built a serious team in-house and gave a lot of bandwidth to SEO. So that's how the mix has been evolving. And now there's content and social media, we're using chatbots and trying to learn and do more things.
Right. So also on digital, there are two things. One is phase one, which is brand building. And second is when you kind of seek ROI on your investment.
Yes.
So how does this process work?
We've been very, very conscious of our ROI.
Right.
So whether it is going on TV, whether it is going on digital, we've measured the success with the same business metrics. So we as a company do not believe in the qualitative metrics of ad lifts and, you know, where does your brand equity score go.
Right.
We've traditionally had the same business metrics to measure the efficacy of any form of advertising. So even today, if we go on to TV, which is really done for brand building, what we really see is how did these metrics move, which are not the qualitative so-called brand health metrics.
Right.
So I think it was very easy for us because the measurement of the metrics was same, and therefore both the sides of marketing were always ROI driven.
So now how do you look at branded content, especially when you have like an array of businesses? So how does it come into play in your marketing strategy or as a part of your marketing strategy?
So I think we haven't done too much when it comes to branded content, right? And I, to be very honest, we've done a few experiments. Some have worked, some haven't given us the ROI like we thought.
Right.
But we are constantly doing stuff.
Right.
A lot of the content that we've played in with at the moment is content that we generate as trend stories, you know, whether it is our real estate business, whether it is Naukri, where we've got job trends, we've got what or surveys that we do with job seekers, etc. So the content that we've played with mostly has been in this space. We've done a few experiments in branded content, especially for Jeevan Sathi, because it's an interesting category.
Right.
There's enough happening.
Yeah. What is the next big trend in marketing?
Sorry. Personalization. How can you serve somebody better? How can you give somebody something that person is looking for and therefore shorten the time span,
right?
And I think that is what is changing. As marketeers, we need to get more data-driven. We need to get more intrinsic to our businesses rather than just the old age era of giving a brief, creating a TVC and running it.
Yeah.
We also have to be on our toes because there's so much of fragmentation happening, so much of new technology emerging every day where you're finding people you know, spending less and less time on one medium.
Right.
And so I think as marketeers, we need to now expand our own scope and become more data-driven, more business-oriented.
Right.
And keep ourselves abreast with all that is happening.
What is one advice that you would want to give to, say, young companies, emerging entrepreneurs, budding marketeers?
I think one thing that we have benefited from is we've always looked as marketing to be very ROI driven.
Right.
We've had the advantage of course, having internet businesses where it's easy to measure. So I think being frugal and sensible is something that worked for us.
Right.
And I would recommend that to everyone. Don't just do things because it's hip and happening.
So don't burn all the cash that you've raised.
Correct. And also don't just, if everybody is doing web series or branded content, please see which business
right.
you will have the maximum success doing something
right.
like that.
Right.
right. So don't just do things for a feather in the cap. Do them if the business really requires
yeah,
them.
Yeah, like for some business, maybe only programmatic works.
Correct.